everybody. This is today's quick little project. We got to bush hog this lot. And if you're familiar with my channel, you'll remember that I bush hogged this lot. Well, actually, we brush cut this lot. This was all overgrown through here along this sort of embankment line here where you couldn't see in there. And there was a homeless encampment right in about where those trees are, right in there. I think actually right might have been around that big oak. And we brush cut all this, and we took out about a single axle dump truck load full of debris from the homeless people, what they left, a bunch of trash and garbage and stuff. So if you want to see that video, you can check it out on my channel. But this is today's job, is just to give this a quick little haircut. It just needs to be maintained since we did all that brush cutting last year. And it's grown up about how I figured it would. Nothing too crazy. I'll probably cut all this on the low flow, but it's we mulched all this down pretty good, and it just needs a quick trim and touch up, really. So I just haven't figured out how I'm going to do this embankment, these embankments yet. I really would like to come just along this edge here, but it's a little steep right here. So I may actually have to cut some of this, because I'd rather cut it like this, so everything kind of goes back that way. And I'm going to turn the cutter down really low, because this stuff is not thick and it's not big. It just needs to be kind of touched. But I hate to be out here on this asphalt in the road. I just got new tracks, but that may be what I end up having to do, just along this embankment, until I can get up to the top and start mowing that. So I'd like to go that way, but I don't want to throw anything out into the road. So sometimes you just got to do what you got to do. But we'll get this mowed down. You guys can come along for the ride, and we'll see how it goes. right, guys, the embankment's done on both sides. Looks pretty good. Don't worry about the stuff in the road. There's a little bit of trash. I'll pick that up, and I got the blower in the truck. We'll blow this whole road off, clean everything up, and then I've got the pole saw too with the trimmer on it, and I'll come back around and kind of clean up around these tighter areas around some of these trees where I couldn't get the grinder in there. So clean this corner up too, but that was a lot quicker than doing all of that by hand, that's for sure, and probably a lot cleaner too because it cuts it a little closer to the ground. So that all is going to look pretty good. So now that's all that's left to do is just bush hog in the middle of this and do a little bit of handwork, and we'll be out of here. So there's a lot of low hang in here, so I think I'll put you guys in the cab. You guys can ride along with me for a little bit, and we'll start bush hogging this down and getting it cleaned up. And I've got the cutter. When I did this, man, I had the cutter, like, I think I was running the machine like a half throttle, if that. So I didn't have that thing spun up very high. I'll probably cut all of this around half throttle or so. It doesn't need much. So I'll probably just drive right up on in here and we'll get started. All right, guys, we're gonna spin this thing up and see what we can do. The last time I came through here, I kind of cut everything about right here last time. They didn't really want me to go much further back. I'm just going to kind of clean this up in here. Because the cutter's turning clockwise, so if it throws anything, it's gonna go that way. So I'm gonna go down and come back around. But I'm not pointing towards the road.
right there. Because I'm OCD like that. All right, I think I can cut back this way now. I think I'm far enough off the road. Right there in that corner by hand. I think I'm gonna go ahead, now that I've kind of got this open like I want to on this side, I can kind of go ahead and start working my way around a circle here a little bit. Now that I've got this edge on the road done, I'll start working my way around. So the clockwise motion of the cutter will throw everything back to the inside of the lot. Else you can do, really. Big old chunks of it. It ain't little, neither. See, there's a big old chunk of it right there. So, I'm gonna work the outer edges of this lot, clean up what I can on the outer end, and just start working my way around and make a circle. Overhang. a house right here. That's like a driveway right there to my left. There was an old driveway. Heading back to the farm and ran into a hailstorm. We had nickel and dime sized hail here out near Ainer yesterday. Between Ainer and Conway, it was crazy. We don't hardly ever get hail here, especially not hail that size. I had to pull over on the side of the road and pull into somebody's driveway and park underneath a tree. And it was nuts. Scared the hell out of me. All of a sudden I was in a bad thunderstorm and it was raining. All of a sudden it just sounded like gunshots hitting the windshield. And I was like, oh my gosh. I couldn't believe it. I haven't seen hail like that here since I was like a little kid. I remember when I was a little kid we had a bad hailstorm one time, but we just don't see hail like that here near the beach. I was pretty shocked. Thank you. those bushes mulched down. I've asked him about that, and he wants to keep them. So, it's kind of like extra stuff that I kind of have to mow around right here. It's kind of a pain, actually. Typically with these lots, it isn't the vegetation that takes a while to cut and work through. It's working around the trees and like the embankments and ditches and all that stuff. That's what takes time. You know, the more trees you have on these lots, the longer it takes to bush hog. It's just more obstacles that you have to maneuver around, work around. It's kind of a pain. About the head cam on the last video, that was cool. I appreciate that, the feedback. That helps me out a lot with the content. And maybe when I do the handwork on this job, I'll put the head cam back on for a minute, and we'll crank the pole trimmer up and do a little bit of handwork in here and around some of those trees in the front, clean them up. I got this thing in the low flow and it's doing really, really well. With this, this is light. This is pretty light stuff. So, all right, well, I'm gonna work my way back through here. We're just about done with this here in another probably 15, 20 minutes. And then I'll break out the pole trimmer and we'll tidy everything up. I'll get the blower out, we'll blow the street off and be done. So hang tight. All right, guys, we're gonna try this head cam thing again. And I'm just gonna clean this corner up a little bit and we'll blow the street off. Yeah.
All right, guys, that's the job. A little bit of hand work. And just that little bit of hand work, I mean, that took like 15 minutes or so for me to kind of work the pole trimmer in there and clean some of that stuff up. Sorry about that. And so, you know, that's why just trying to cut all of that by hand through there would have just taken forever to do all that. So kind of sucked having to put my new tracks on the asphalt, but there just wasn't any really way to cut this embankment. And it's pretty steep right here, you know, right there. You couldn't really be able to drive that and cut that very well through this little part here. So that's the way it had to be done. And not the most efficient way, but it was better than doing it by hand. It'd have been nice if I'd have had the mini down here. I could have just taken the mini and just gone right down it, this embankment, worked my way down. But there's no point bringing two machines out here, plus the mini's in the shop for a seal on one of the final drives is having to get replaced. So yeah, all this cleaned up really nicely. So we'll have to just keep an eye out, see if it's going to need another cutting come the fall. We'll see how much it grows back up, but this will last at least until October, so not too bad. So hope you guys enjoyed. It's Wednesday, and trying to get back at it. Missy and I moved into our new place yesterday. Spent the whole day moving. I hate moving. But we got pretty much settled in and a few more things to do, but we're just about there. So, all right, well, I'm gonna wrap this up. And one of the guys that works over here at this place, he came over here and flagged me down while I was working. And he's got a project right behind this shop over here that we're gonna do. It's actually two projects, one behind the shop, and then we're gonna trim some of that stuff that's hanging over that fence there inside the shop. So we're gonna do that next week with the mini when I get it back. I don't know exactly what day, but more stuff to do. So I'm gonna chain down the machine and we're gonna get out of here for the day. So I will check you guys later.